about how you spend your time, your money, your resources. And for the nations, I just encourage you to pray. Take my our prayer card, nothing else. Pray for us 5 minutes every day. Bible to Racing World, it just gave out the new prayer card for the nations. Great. Pray for the nations. Because they will make a difference. One day, eternity. Do you actually think you can live forever? Not just 8 years? Forever? You see some of the people that you prayed for? Or some of the nations? They're going to be there? With Christ? So consider, how can you intentionally in this neighborhood make disciples of nations? There are hundreds of different nations in this neighborhood. 95% of international students go into college, never visit an American home. How about going to local college and say, going to international market and say, we can open our home for one of the international students. You don't have to invite all of them, just one. Don't invite all of them. Just one or two. It's not, all you need to do is just cook a meal that you're going to cook anyways. And you're going to have leftovers, you know that. Just do that. Be intentional. Trust God's promises. We come from different, all of us, different contexts. Some of you feel that this message is going to end up your own dream. Right. Jesus saves you from American dream. That's reality. What if you're going to give an extra $100 or extra 5% to missions? You cannot buy a new car. Trust God. What if you're not going to cheat in your taxes and you're not going to make as much? Well, trust God. Be obedient. What if you choose to share Christ with one of our workmates and he's going to reject us? Oh, I feel bad about it. Well, trust God. Some of you, what if I'm going to make a public confession of faith to this church and get baptized? You're thinking, can I do that? Well, trust God and be obedient to Him. And some of you, what if God is calling you to be next 10 or 20 years in China with language you never know? You didn't have that in class in high school. He's going to start stirring your heart. Well, trust God. What if I have to confess a sin to someone and it's going to be embarrassing? Well, God already knows it. So can you go to the accountability department, share it, and get experiential redemption and joy? Well, trust God. What if some of you need to confront someone? We often miss that part. In the gospel community, actually lovingly sometimes true. Some of you may be in that kind of situation. Can I do it? Well, trust God's promises. So, I thank you for opportunity to be here. And I just encourage you to stay faithful to the gospel and live it out. So that radical way. I don't know if church is appropriate, but I know God's going to keep His promises. I know that. Father, thank you for this church. I thank you for the lives and what I've heard even just in the past couple of months. Thank you that they want to give to Ladimu. Thank you for that. Lord, I pray that you increase our faith in you. Your promises for the new earth with the resurrected body, where you're going to be with us forever. Find us faithful. Find us faithful when we are discouraged or quit. Help us to see Christ. Lord, I pray that you would stir someone's hearts to go some of those unreached nations that don't have even Bibles. They're so smart they can work with languages, Father. Do that. Lord, I pray that somebody would be courageous to go to a neighbor the first time or go to a school to visit an international student. Lord, do that. Thank you that you have promised to be with us when we make disciples. In the hope of the resurrection and your coming, setting all things, we pray in Christ's name. Amen.
Jesus, I'll stand with you. As God's been moving this morning, maybe there's a decision that you need to make. Ask Mikko if you wouldn't mind just coming and standing up in the front with Lisa and Buster and the other pastors, Davis and Gerald, wherever you are. Are you willing to trust God this morning? I heard that message. I need to. Where are you at? What decision do you need to make this morning for Christ? Are you trusting His promises? Maybe you need to get baptized. You want to come and make that public and say, yeah, that's me. What decision do you need to make for Christ this morning? Come, we're here, we're available. We're here to pray with you. Let's continue to worship as God continues to move this world. Continues to work. Don't leave here this morning without making a decision for Christ. If that means continuing to be faithful in your walk, that's it. If it's something else, if it's a first-time decision, whatever it is, don't leave here without making sure that you've done business with God this morning. I want to introduce my friends. This is Charles. Charles, come stand up next to me. And Melanie. This week to my office and just said, hey, Pastor, be it a witness wherever you go. They accepted Christ on the streets in the upper room, right off of, is it White Avenue? Or Gary? It's off of Gary. Somebody led them to the Lord a couple months ago. And they're coming this morning. Amen. If you guys want to come down in a minute here, we'll conclude. And just shake their hands, tell them you're glad that they're part of this family. That'd be great. Let me pray for us, and then we will be dismissed. Jesus, we love you so much. Thank you, God, for the message of really your faithfulness to us. God, help us to be faithful to you. God, we love you. Thank you for making us one and whole as a body, as we try to walk this life, stumbling as we do, God, in your grace, may we leave with that grace in mind, sharing it with everybody who we come in contact with. We love you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I'm going to ask Mikko and Heidi to come up too, and as you guys are dismissed, come by and shake hands and say we love you. So